Dave Goucher, and he joins us right now. First things first, Dave, you are on a bus promoting this team that is so beloved, not only in Nevada, but all over the region. Please share.
Hi, Tony.
Hello.
Yeah, somewhere between Reno and Boise right now. So there's the highway, the desert, and there we are. So, yeah, we're so they did this last year, too. They did make this road trip to really a lot of our TV territory, Montana, Idaho. But this year it's going, we just left Reno. Next up is Boise and then Jackson Hole and then Salt Lake City. So I'm heading to Boise here with a bunch of people on the bus. My partner Shane Knight is going to join us there, and we're going to have a fun few days for sure.
Dave, talk about the excitement about this bus trip compared to last year. How far this team has come from an expansion team to now. This promotion going around, promoting this team has to be quite something this summer.
Yeah, it's great, Billy. You know, they really, today, Brad Hunt joins us in Reno, and people were lined up for an hour to get his autograph. And it's a whole different deal now, to your point. You know, last year, they had just kind of put the team together. They hadn't played any games, quite obviously. So coming off the greatest expansion, you know, season in the history of sports, it's all together. They're different this time around. So the turnout today in Reno was great. And, you know, Boise coming up next. So it's been, I think it's important for us, you know, as much as the team is beloved in Vegas, the fan base is really kind of throughout the Rocky Mountain region. So it's good, I think, to get out from that, you know, that bubble in Vegas a little bit, if you will, to branch out to where there are Golden Knights fans, you know, even throughout the Rocky Mountain region.
We were just discussing the William Karlsson contract. 1 year, $5.25 million. You saw him all year long as he was putting up this remarkable campaign. How about what he brings and just how valuable he is to that club?
Yeah, I think a lot of it, Tony, you guys hit on. I mean, his all-around game is really, really grown, especially this past season. And I think that his ability to play in that offensive role, he never really had that in his time in either Anaheim or Columbus, obviously. And he's a guy that when he had an opportunity to play between Marchessault and Smith, really flourished. And I think they flourished with him as their center. So, you know, they were one of the best lines in the league last year. They were fantastic together. But for Karlsson, his ability to play the game with a lot of speed, to subtly seems like he's always in the right place on the ice. If he was going to look at his game, the area he'd like to maybe improve upon the most is faceoffs. There's been areas where maybe he struggled in that category. But other than that, now the big challenge for him, you guys kind of touched on it a little bit, is can he replicate what he did last year? Can he build on that? Is he going to be a perennial 40-goal scorer? And I guess we'll find that out starting this year.
David, is there cell towers out there where you're driving to get reception? You showed me that picture. All I saw was desert. That's pretty good job on the bus getting some cell towers to get you some video of yourself.
That's how we roll, Billy. That's how we do it.
Nicely done.
I'm not sure where we are. I don't know where we are, but we're going towards Boise. I know that much.
You were referring to the bubble earlier, and I think it's worth revisiting because when I was there to visit you just a short while ago, we saw outside a restaurant a countdown to the start of the season. We just put it up. Beer House, Las Vegas, 54 days until VGK. There's a lot going on in Vegas during the summer, yet there's so much passion for this club that there's a countdown on. Wow.
Yeah, you know what it is too, Tony. They're the only game in town if you think about it, right? And to your point, I mean, the Vegas Strip has world-class entertainment, but last season the Golden Knights were the toughest ticket to get on the Strip, and the Beer House is not far from T-Mobile Arena. I may have had a beverage or two there on occasion. The chances are good, but no, it's a great spot before and after games, and it's just how passionate people are about this team. They really love it, and, you know, how could you not, especially with what they did, not only on the ice, but off the ice. I think that's the area that, an area they were very proud of as well, is to become ingrained in the community. So yeah, it's you know, still a couple of months away, and or a little less than that now, but you know, people can't wait to get it going again.
A lot to admire. Dave Goucher, enjoy the trip. Thanks so much for joining us.
All right, guys, see you.